Harley Benton, the kings of making very affordable stuff, surprisingly good, have released a new range of bass amps and cabinets. Amongst things like an 8x10 cabinet for just 300 and a few bucks, which is crazy. They also made this, a 150 watt bass combo that can stand like this, or like this, or how about this? This also works. Or this, and this? Let's check it out. Hi, my name is Gregor, our bass player for today is Frank It, and here we have the Harley Benton Solid Bass 150C combo. With its 250 bucks, it's still cheap, and in this price range, there's really not much competition there, especially not with this kind of horsepower. But let's try to look behind it and see if this thing is actually any good. We have two inputs and, as far as I can tell, useless clip LED because it never clips. We have a tuner which works and your bass will eventually be in tune, but there are faster ways to get there if I'm really honest. In the upper row we have a 4-band EQ, a master volume and a DI out. Below that we have an effects loop, a headphone out, an aux in with a volume control, the input gain for your bass with a mute switch and a surprisingly decent compressor. The combo weighs 18.5 kilos, which would be almost comfortable to carry around if it was a little bit more compact, but I guess if that's your main concern, then the whole wedge thing just isn't for you, just get something more compact. The 12-inch speaker gets some top-end support from a 3-inch tweeter, which actually sounds really good, but still here we're getting to the one point of this amp that I think needs some improvement. The amp isn't super noisy, but there's a bit of a hiss coming through, and I think it can be a little bit annoying. Harley Benton could either just filter it out in the amp or make the tweeter adjustable, or even better, maybe do both. You won't notice this in a band practice, but if you're playing alone at home, it can be again a little bit annoying. But I really don't want to complain too loud, because in context of the price, I think this is kind of an acceptable flaw. By the way, you can unplug the internal speaker like this and then use the speaker with another amp, or of course the amp with a bigger cabinet. All in all, this amp is loud, it's flexible, the compressor sounds really good. I think if your budget is limited and you just need something decent for band practice, go for it. It's absolutely okay. Yeah, and that's it from me today. Thank you very much for watching. I'm planning on doing more tests with these new amps, so maybe write me in the comments what you want to see next. One of the cabinets, one of the amps. Just let me know. That's it from me today. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time and bye bye.